I say I have bird distractibility disorder, and sometimes I'll be walking along on my path to class, finding the science building, and then I'll hear something. And then I'll just turn slightly, and then I'll get on another path, and I've gotten lost before that way. Well, actually quite a few times. In 1974, the first time I went to college, I wanted to get a degree in biology, and that lasted about 2 days, and then I couldn't figure out how to use the microscopes or the periodic table in chemistry, and it just all seemed really overwhelming, and I didn't know how to learn as a blind person, and nobody knew how to teach me, so I gave that up and went into social work, which was a fine plan for my life, but I never got over wanting to know about nature and biology and science. So when I turned half a century, I decided I'm going to go back and learn about this stuff. I went to the career office and I'm like, this is what I want to do. I want to learn about nature, and then I want to learn it so I can show other blind kids and tell them about it in a way that we can understand it. So they sent me to Dr. Gelderloos, and they said, that's called environmental studies. Blind people really can learn about birds. First, we identify them by their song and their call, and then we learn about their habitat and their nesting and their migrating, and just what I originally wanted to do, learn about nature as a blind person. So it kind of fit into my original goal, and it was something that I could find success with fairly rapidly, and then I was able to share it with kids. Other people use sight to identify birds. They also use their ears, but you know, I want them to know that there are things you can do in life as a blind person. There are ways of using his hearing, his sense of touch, his sense of smell, and he can be just as successful in life. He doesn't have to see everything to feel like he can accomplish things. So really, that's the part that excites me the most, because he's excited and he is finding success in doing something with his other senses rather than sight.